Wangashi Mouto, a well-known Brooklyn artist and sculptor. Wangashi's life began in Nairobi, Kenya on June 22, 1975. As a child, Wangashi was brought up to have a deep love and respect for her Kikuyu ancestry. This meant that she would have all love and respect for Mother Earth and all her living things, including plants, animals, and humans. This love for Earth soon developed into a curiosity of both animals and lands outside of Kenya. At the young age of 17, Wangashi's curiosity led her to leave Kenya and her family behind to study at IB United World College of Atlantic Wales. Only after leaving Kenya did Wangashi's passion for art begin to flourish. In the 1990s, she moved to New York to focus on fine art and anthropology at the New School of Social Research and Pearson School of Art Design. She earned a BFA from Cooper Union for the Advancement of the Art and Science in 1996 and a master's degree in sculpture from Yale University in 2000. At her new home in New York City, Mouto began to nurture and began her career as an artist. Through various mediums, she was able to tell the stories and convey the issues that has been troubling her since her life in Kenya. Her work discusses issues involving gender, race, war, globalization, colonization, and the fetishization of the black female body. In March of 2013, Wangashi's ideology and heritage were put on display in her Fantastic Journey exhibit at the Nasher Art Museum at Duke University. Such as Suspended Playtime. Once upon a time, she said, "I'm not afraid," and her enemies became afraid of her. And A Piece to End of Eating Everything, a video she did in collaboration with singer-songwriter Ashanti Gold. Each image is meant to convey a power inside an individual. In Wangashi's own words,
"The power for me in this is to keep the figure, the story of female in the center, to keep discussing and talking about women as active, as protagonists, good, bad, whatever it is that they are part of the reason that we're here. That's important for me, not to kind of marginalize us and give us bits on the side here and there."
This ideology is seen in a mixed medium piece, 100 Lavish Months of Bushwhack. Created in 2004, this collage is 68.5 inches by 42 inches. It features cut and paste print paper with watercolor, synthetic plier paint, and pressure-sensitive stickers on transparent size paper. Wangashi used cutouts from various sources such as Vogue, National Geographic, outdated ethnographic surveys, pornography, and botanical garden illustrations. Wangashi incorporated two female figures in her painting. The focal point of the image is a quasi-reptilian woman that appears in both an elegant and aggressive stance. Her body is a mixture of human-like features, animals, and machinery. She has hippo mouths for hands, a high heel stiletto foot, and pools of blood coming from her one missing foot and her head. She has a human mouth, two eyes, and an ear. The second female figure is at the lower right-hand side of the artwork. Her skin is a darker brown than the previous one, with pinkish-white blotches all over her body. She appears in a more human-like fashion and is holding up the larger woman. There is negative space in the background, creating a sharp contrast between the colorful figures in the foreground and a monotone gray background. The lines of the grass and the implied lines of the two figures creates a sense of movement within the painting. Her body and face hidden within the foreground of the artwork by the blaze of grass. Her face is equally as distorted as the larger woman's. However, her presence gives a much more vulnerable and innocent feeling. In 100 Lavish Months of Bushwick, Wangashi gives a physical representation of the mental abuse and distortion a female faces due to society's expectation and manipulation of the female body. In American society, the female body is often over-sexualized for entertainment of the male viewer to sell various fantasies and objects, such as clothing and magazines, food, sporting events, and even music. Upon no other race has this marketing strategy more negatively affected and had a deeper impact than on the black female. The two female figures in Wangashi's own description are sensitivity charts, barometers tracking the health or more often the sickness of any given society's own body politics. The focal image is the lower end of the sensitivity chart. She has distorted and mutilated her body in order to be deemed worthy of society's gaze, despite the fact of her appearance being inhuman and grotesque. Her disformities is considered natural and normalized by society. The second image is the higher end of the sensitivity chart. She represents the natural and realistic beauty women want to be represented as in society. However, she is forced to hide and upheld the distorted figure of the female body placed upon women by the male-dominated society. Both figures watch the viewer as the viewer watches them, giving a sense of awareness of their representation to society. Wangashi is from Kikuyu descent. The Kikuyu people in Nigeria have a deep love and respect for nature. They view nature and trees as the ultimate status of life. In many of their rituals, they plant trees to symbolize the birth of a family member or a baby, and bury their dead ones near a tree. Furthermore, Wangashi often employs a female figure in her work. Using these two ideas, I created my artwork. My artwork is called Death of Mother Earth. As you can see in the photo, I am wearing white. White often symbolizes purity and is associated with nature. To be one with nature is the purest state of being, in my opinion, because the cycle of life, death, and rebirth is always seen within nature. In the photo, I photograph myself with a dying rose bush and with bloody tears to symbolize the abuse and the neglect that mankind has brought upon nature. Eventually, nature will die, and therefore mankind will die as well. These are my questions.